Joining us live by Skype is Dr. Wallace Williams, President, African Goals Development Initiative. Thank you very much for joining us on the news. Do you agree with Dr. Ezekwesili that Africa must be accorded compensation by China for its COVID-19 mistakes?
Yes, we should and we must. Africa, just like Italy, just like France, just like UK, just like the US, who are going to go for reparations, Africa must as well too. And one of the key things is that for reparations, we have lost so much. We have lost trade, we have lost man hours, we have lost our economies, and all the deaths of China that we've inherited must be cancelled. In addition, we must revoke all contracts, visas, and deport the millions of Chinese back to China. That has to be the stance of Africa.
There have been videos from different quarters showing the maltreatment of Africans in China, despite the denial from the Chinese government. What are your observations and findings in this regard?
Well, let's go first to the head of China, the President Xi Jinping. And he said, right, that as far as he is concerned, Africans, right, what we are education is in disorder, administration is corrupt, health is deplorable, but religion is the fastest growing project that Africa has. And therefore, he has disseminated that down to these Africans as nothing more than religious fanatics, rather than to be taken seriously as human beings.
There have also been calls from notable people on the need to protect the interests of Nigerians that are living in China. What are your recommendations to the federal government on this matter?
Well, Nigeria has started and Guinea has started. Nigeria has said that they will evacuate, and I think that's the correct thing to do, because after all the lies the Chinese are saying, that it's not so, it's just misinformation, disinformation and spins, they've been caught with their pants down. They are liars in all respects and cannot be trusted. And everyone has seen virally what they've been doing to African brothers and sisters. Guinea has said that they will deport the Chinese in their country and ensure that they get their people back to Guinea. Nigeria said that they are going to start. We did say it in the last interview that the federal government and also all African countries should get some aircraft together and bring the Africans back home and take that type of nonsense anymore. And Africa has to stand up for its rights. You know, Ambassador Chihombre Kiao, the former AU ambassador, Professor PLO Lumumba, Dr. Mumbi Seraki, they've all, with one voice as activists, have said, we must get our Africans back home, and we must start the process of getting the Chinese back home.
There are fears about the Chinese invading the African business territories. Do you share these views, and what would be your worries about it?
There's no worry. We must put some things in place if we are going to do business with China at all. And that is, we must adopt the Dubai model and also the Ghana model. Okay, if you're coming to Africa to do business and not to rape, plunder, and pillage our resources, then you must enact a partnership. Dubai does it. Ghana is starting to do it. 70% of the partnership belongs to the local. 80% of the labor force belongs to the local. And we share the profits in that way, if you want to bring your money and your equipment and your technical know-how. Also, you will transfer that technology and intellectual property to the locals, and you will be leaving. You will not be there forever. You cannot For example, in China, buy land. We must insist that we cannot own land either. You cannot be permanent residents in Africa. You are transient. Transient business people come and do business and go. We have to take a very tough stance now. I think it will no longer be business as usual. Business will be unusual now, and business must be partnership with Africans in every country with every resource that we have. And we must now go towards having our own single currency. We must now go to enacting the Act for Act and making sure we start to trade between ourselves and build our own prosperity, not for Africa to be pillaged again. We have gone through that for 400 years. We cannot anymore. There must be a stop. An African Development Goals Initiative is setting agendas where we are going to have yearly agendas for Africa and the African continent, whether it's health for 1 year, education for the next. All the things that Jinping talked about, we will have to correct. Yes, and it is African leadership and the youth of Africa that is going to change the paradigm.
I want to thank you very much, Doctor, for joining us on the news.
Thank you.
Stay safe.